As far as I'm concerned, the Barong is the king of gods, good and evil. And I believe that we have to be very fair and open about both sides of humanity, of music, of anything in life. That's what it is to me.
We are in a little village called Montreux, where we rented this small cottage. We brought everybody from the Barong family here to make music together, collaborate with each other. Basically just live here for a week with no distractions at all, just focused on making music.
Everybody that comes in is kind of forced to collab with somebody else, to work like for 5, 6, 7 hours on a song.
We are invited by Barong family to make as loud as music as possible.
Everybody has his own process. Not only are we creating like a lot of music, but I see like everybody is getting a glimpse into everybody's work progress, and everybody got tricks and tips and stuff. It's basically a week like school.
We started the label not from like a business perspective, but more from a fan perspective. Sesko or Wevek, they had trouble releasing their music. We were like, oh, we got some money, we can like maybe get a label together and like release it. And we've been doing it ever since.
Eventually, it's not a label, it's like this big band with like separate divisions. But in the end, we like perform together, but everybody has his own identity.
Yellow Claw is just an example of how hard work and the guts to be unique and to not go with other people's flow, it pays off. They never went for the easy way. They always went their way and they did it like they want to do it. It's really inspiring to work with people like Yellow Claw. Jim and Nils are next level when it comes to music management. Even if you have no idea how it works, you can see it. Like if you look at Yellow Claw and how they interact with their fans, how they do their show, how they do their videos, how they do their social media, it's very good. Yeah, this is Motown Music Cafe in Venlo. Hometown of me and Jim. We just played for 50 euros and a bottle of booze. When you play for 5,000 or 10,000 people, it's just play big drops and a lot of energy. But when you play here, you have to do it completely different. You have to have a build up and you have to leave some room for people to sometimes talk. So it's completely different. First weekend of July 2015 was our first show.
Right.
And a lot happened. The charts, like the iTunes chart in Holland, the top 5. It grew so fast.
To jump in this thing called Moxie was all new for me.
The moment when you have to make a really hard decision that might let you lose everything, if you do that, they will get something in return. It's like that ancient sacrifice thing. Like you have to sacrifice something to get somewhere. And that's what we did. And it went like textbook, perfect.
I think it's cool that Barong family is willing to release stuff that probably other labels won't release because it's either too experimental or too hard. And I think that's why Barong family is growing in popularity now. I think even the guys are surprised about how big the label has become.
Hey. Yeah, Looney Tunes is into the harder genres, like the hard style, hardcore thing, for a long time. So they have all these packs of samples,
yeah,
with boom, boom, really rough sounds, and really inspirational to see him working.
Yeah. And it works together well because yeah. We know the hard style and they know the trap, and we like yeah. both the things.
Yeah, yeah.
Die vind ik vet.
Die is
het. Zit lekker soepje.
They wanted to make a label more Dutch, more European based.
Where we all could yeah, release
our stuff.
Yeah, without all the hustle of the other labels.
Maar hij moet eventjes gebroken worden in zijn ritme, zeg maar.
Ja, precies, sowieso. En die sound is ook een beetje...
The studio sessions are in small bedrooms with tiny ass speakers, like back to basics, and it gives new inspiration. And yeah. just hanging out together, all of us, gives a new kind of vibe. And it's super quiet here. You only hear birds and 808 kick drums. So it's
in the end, it's supposed to be the first Bronx Family collaborations album. 10 to 15 songs, all like crazy collaborations people didn't expect. It's basically an all-star lineup, like a festival, but then in a farm.
Thank you.
You have gelijk, you have gelijk. You have gelijk. Come on.
Woo! Papa, have your shot, chill, man.
That was my party trick.
Samad. So, Barong mean is the symbol of the good spirit, and they used for ceremony. When there's a ceremony, they stay at the temple, and if there's not a temple ceremony, the Barong will stay at the priest's house. The priest will give offering every day
okay.
to the Barong.
If you look around, there's a lot of beauty, and we gotta embrace it. This island has different religions, different people, but it works out. We have to make this work together, and that's what we're doing as a label, you know.
Well, Mike Civello, he's like one of the youngest guys in the Barong family.
Mike Civello, he texted me this morning. Yesterday on the main stage of Tomorrowland, 5 of his songs got played. That's a lot for a young guy like him, so he's got a very bright future in front of him.
Dat laatste stukje van de vocal vind ik keihard.
Ja, maar hier komt nog een extra stuk, hè? Er zit nog een stuk achteraan, want dat hoor je
niet.
Ja,
we hebben nu natuurlijk gewoon weg.
He's real into trying to find the perfect groove for his kind of music.
Wow! Wow!
Nou, dat is geen vogel.
Nee, maar dat is wel goed. Oh.
Always looking for, you know, weird sounds and still danceable. When you hear his music, you think, you know, it's like jumping all time in the studio or something. Like, it's very energetic, very focused, working on the sounds, working on the mix.
Wow, maar je hebt op een plaat een vocal ingesproken.
Thank you.
Cesco, we often call him like the golden child. Production wise, he's a fucking genius. As a DJ, he's really talented. As a performer, kind of has the whole package. The funny thing with him is like, if he walks into the room, everybody's looking at it. Having him on the labels, I feel really lucky.
Wild, way too social for me. He always talks with everybody and I'm like, okay, cool man. But also, when it comes to work, very dedicated, lots of energy. Same with his character, basically. Like his character is very energetic too. He always has energy.
We're at my home, where I was born, grew up, and still live. This is where I made music for 10 years with a really small setup. I think I made all my tunes until now. I made it in here. I was just playing around, trying to entertain myself, basically, because there wasn't really music around that I really felt good with or something. So I just made it myself.
Weewag, fucking love Weewag.
He changed EDM because there were a lot of big drops and hard synths on drops, and then he came with this crazy animal influences. Everybody was like, holy shit. From that point on, everybody started using those sounds. He was the first one.
Weewag, his music sounds like jungle warriors on elephants discovers a drum computer.
Something with Cesco earlier today, which was kind of fun, and we already did a couple of sessions in Holland. Really easy working with him because we like a lot of the same things.
That's all random.
The Cesco is really hyped up, which is good because I'm really laid back, so he kind of keeps me focused during the session. But then again, our focus is all over the place because we keep on like listening to a song and then going back to the song that we were working on, then let's do something else. Most labels are focused on how are we gonna make as much money as possible, because it's hard these days, and Barong Family does exactly the opposite. They give out music for free and make sure that all these producers release their music and go on tour and make a name for themselves.
For us, ADC Vegas is a special place. Two years ago, we played there for the first time. It was one of our first real big shows in the USA, and it changed everything for us. And it's a very special festival.
We hear it all the time. People just drove like 8 or 9 or 10 hours. They go all out, like outfit-wise. That movement it's more special. Me and Jim always had this vision of, after we released like a bunch of songs to like multiple labels like around the world, we just concluded like nobody really gives a shit. You deliver your music to a label and that's that.
It's an intimate process making music, and then just to like send out your beats or your songs to some guy you never met, you never shook his hand or anything, or never like looked him in the eye, it's a hard thing. And that's where we came up with the family part of Barong Family. It's one big family and there's like this circle of trust.
I'm just very curious where Barong Family is gonna be in like a couple of years. I can't wait to see like Maxi tour like internationally, to see Cesco taking over the world. This whole new genre he created for like the younger artists like Mike Cervello and like all those acts, and also Weewag. I can't wait, like see them like really rise up. They say it's lonely at the top, and I don't want to say we're at the top, but it's way more fun to have this success and share it with like your best friends.
EDC!